Good evening and happy Sabbath, brothers and sisters in Christ. We're so thankful since God has given us another week to celebrate His goodness as we celebrate our midweek program this evening. To start our worship, this evening we'll be singing one inspiration. It's found in our hymnals, hymn number 343, All the Way.
Grace for every trial, feeds
Mayong gabi, mga igsoon. Og welcome sa atong midweek prayer worship dinhi sa Cebu City Adventist Church. Ako usab gi-welcome ang atong mga igsoon nga naa karon sa ilang panimalay og sa bisag unsa nga lugar nga nagtan-aw karon pinaagi sa atong online streaming. I hope nga naa mo sa maayong kahimtang niining gabi una. Atong daygon og pasalamatan ang atong Ginoo, mga igsoon, sa iyang padayon nga kaluoy, grasya o mga panalangin sa matag sa kanato. O gato sa pasalamatan, kini nga kahigayunan nga sa diin makapaminaw na usab kita o mga mensahe, bahin sa maing panglawas o bahin sa pulong sa Ginoo. Ining gabi una, mga igsoon, ang atong speaker maghahatag sa mensahe sa pulong sa Ginoo o sa siya ka internal medicine specialist, og ang iyang subspecialty is pulmonary and critical care. Usa-usab siya ka chair sa Department of Internal Medicine at Adventist Hospital Cebu, og training officer sa Department of Internal Medicine, Southwestern University Hospital. Ang atong magsusulti nining gabi una, mga kaigsoonan, is no other than Dr. Michelle Napigkit. Sa dili pa nako ihatag ang panahon sa atong song leader alang sa opening song, ako usang basahon ang atong sintro sa pagtuon nga makita diha sa Genesis kapitulo 2 bersikulo 7. Nagaingon, "Then the Lord God formed a man from the dust of the ground and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and the man became a living being." Atong isintro, atong huna-huna o kasing-kasing, mga kaigsoonan, samtang kita mag-awit sa pagdaig sa atong Ginoo o samtang kita maminaw sa iyang mga mensahe sa pulong. Once again, maayong gabi o welcome kaninyong tanan.
To start our worship this evening, I'm inviting everyone to please sing with me. Our opening song is found in our Adventist hymnals, hymn number 295, "Leaning on the Everlasting Arms." Requesting everyone to please rise. Thank you.
worship, what a joy divine, leaning on the everlasting arms. What a blessedness, what a peace is mine, leaning on the everlasting arms. Safe and secure from all alarms, leaning, leaning, leaning on the everlasting arms. Oh, how sweet to walk in this pilgrim way, leaning on the everlasting arms. The path grows from day to day, leaning on the everlasting arms, leaning, leaning, safe and secure from all alarms, leaning, leaning. Leaning on the everlasting arms. What have I to dread? What have I to fear? Leaning on the everlasting arms, I have blessed peace with my Lord so near. Leaning on the everlasting safe and secure from all alarms, leaning, leaning, leaning on the everlasting arms.
Let us all kneel for our prayer. Most gracious, kind, and loving Heavenly Father, Lord, we would like to thank you for this privilege of worship. Thank you, dear God, for gathering us here in the midst of the week. Thank you for being with us. Dear Lord, we come before your throne with humility in our hearts, accepting that we are a sinner in need of your grace. Dear God, this evening, in a special prayer, Lord, I would like to pray for your people. May you be with each one of us. And dear God, for your instrument this evening, dear God, may you be with her, dear Lord. Hide her behind the shadow of your cross and use her, dear God, as an instrument and as a channel to communicate your words to each one of us. Help us, dear Lord, to focus to your words, empty us from ourselves, and fill us with your Holy Spirit. We would like to surrender this worship unto you. Forgive us from all of our sins. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
My love is not my own, it Thank you, Sister Antoinette, for that beautiful offering of praise. No, it certainly set our hearts for tonight's worship. Good evening, Church. Mayong gabi sa atong mga kaigsuunan nga naa diri karon sa simbahan, as well as to our friends, our brothers and sisters who are worshiping with us in the different social media platforms. No, we are indeed happy that we have this wonderful opportunity to talk about health. No, if you've noticed, our past nightly sermons or topics for our worship were all about the health. And our different brothers and sisters who are experts of that as well were the ones who gave the talk. Now, this tonight's talk is not just about our physical health. It's also something It is also about something that will nourish our souls as well. So I thought of something that will relate to my subspecialty, which is pulmonary, so that is why breath of life. I actually have two key texts for tonight's worship. The first is Genesis 2:7, and it reads, "And the Lord formed man out of the dust of the ground and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and man became a living soul." So imagine, no? The Lord or God started to create man probably just from a lump of dirt. Basin lapok ra to. Basin usa ra to kakumo sa lapok, no? That we don't know. But transforming it into a beautiful creature or creature like his image, his likeness, no? God must have done something very nice. That's why he celebrated the entire creation week with the Sabbath rest. Tonight, we will not just be talking about the physical air, no? What is it about the hangin nga atong gina higup-higup every day, no? We will also talk about our spiritual oxygen. And later on, we were all gonna be dealing with our second key text, which is found in Ezekiel 37. Unsay sulod sa atong hangin, mga kaigsuunan? This may be a review for some, but kindly take a look at the pie chart there. Ang kaniyatong atmospheric air is actually not made up of 100% oxygen. Would you believe, no? Na it is the majority of the composition sa atong atmospheric air is nitrogen. Around 70, almost 80%, and only 21% of that is oxygen. The rest, mga other gases like your argon, your helium, probably carbon dioxide from the exhalation and products of combustion, and then the water vapor, kana lang. Gamay ra kaayo, but that is what we need, no? A very small portion. So, Duke, mga tana mo, unsa man jud gamit anang oxygen, pwede ra na wala? I don't think so. Every cell in our body needs oxygen to process, especially ang pag-convert sa atong food into energy. Without energy, all our bodily processes will not go about its usual work. Kung makinapata, mukagar, mapaong, maguba. No? So what are the roles of oxygen in our body? So it is even stated that oxygen is the most important element for the human beings. It sustains life on this planet, mga kaigsuunan. 90% of the oxygen in the 90% of the processes in the cell rather is run by oxygen itself. So therefore, needed niya to metabolize or break down our food so we can have useful energy. So again, ayaw mo kahadlok ani mga kaigsuunan, mura ni ang last nga murag kuyaw-kuyaw baminaon. If you remember the physiology or katong biology na to sa una, the mitochondria is coined as the powerhouse of the cell. So, mura lang siya og kuan kanang murag panpan tan-aon. That mitochondria actually is the powerhouse of the cell. It is where energy is converted. Yeah, kung sa chemical pa na siya, biochemical reaction, oxygen plays a role. Dili ma-transfer ang mga electrons niya, dito ka buhat og energy from it, so magluya ka. That is how important oxygen is. So kani, the fetus is actually termed as a parasite. Iya raman jug higupon ang tanan nutrients sa mama. Parasite gin siya, no? Murag kuto. But actually, the fetus does not breathe. Oh, na siya'y baby nga ilong-ilong, but it doesn't really breathe because it swims or is afloat in the amniotic fluid nga gi-contain sa gestational sac. Inside sa matres ni mother, naa sila'y taas nga pusod. Taas kay na actually ang pusod, maglimbod-limbod mang gani na usahay. So the pusod or the umbilicus is attached to the placenta or the inunlan. Si placenta, attached na siya sa matres ni mama. So si fetus nga si parasite, sige na siyang pangayo ni mama tanan. Yang food, yang nutrients, share sila blood supply. And of course, the oxygen from the mother dito sa niya gikuha. My husband and I love to swim. So, usahay mo, undang na lang mika ng mga hapdos na mga skin from the sunburn. So, we are fascinated with, we are not actually certified divers, but we are fascinated with the marine life. So, you know, how does the fish or how do the fishes or the sea creatures breathe, no? They have gills. Sa ato ang sa Bisaya, it's called hasang, no? Kaning hasang, the gills, they are full of mga blood vessels, no? Kani sila, they take in water, kani atong mga isda, and then, so, mga nga sila, musod ang tubig. It enters the mouth, and then they force it out of their hasang, kanang naadiri sa ilhang ulo dapit. So, as the water is passed over the thin walls, that is where gas exchange happens. Muragyapog sa lungs na to, gikan sa heart. Turtles are different, di ba? Lahi man siya, na gani siya'y kapay-kapay. Wala man siya'y pariha sa isda, nga hasang-hasang. The turtles have their cloacal opening. Kung sa ato ani humans, the cloaca can be likened to our anal opening. Murag ang lubot na to, ang ana. So, they expand their cloaca at tumusod ang tubig. And then they draw water into it. Ilahan na pong ishant dito sa ilang bursa. So, dito po mahitabo ang gas exchange. Yeah, they are amphibians, diba? They can get out of the water and not die. And so, because of the technology, our humans also, especially the divers, have their scuba. Karon pagyud ko ani mga kaigsuunan. Scuba means self-contained underwater breathing apparatus. Nagyuday siya. It's a mnemonic. This is probably the best known apparatus for breathing underwater. Mo nang maabot sila tagpila ka feet sa ilahang mga expeditions. So scuba gear actually is a compressed air. Dili na siya 100% oxygen like what we give to our patients in the hospital. This also contains nitrogen and other gases. That is why if they are divers, ascend too fast. Kinaamantan na sila ika ng pila ka feet, maghinay-hinay na silag pasag ka. Dili mo na sila mukalit o ka ng kapakapapataas. If they do that, they get bends or nitrogen narcosis. Kay paspas kayo musood ba? So the remedy for that is we put our divers inside an hyperbaric oxygen chamber. Nga murag, misulod silag murag kapsul-kapsul niya. Pahanginan sila dito 100% oxygen for a certain number of hours para mupuli to, mo-diffuse out ang nitrogen, musud ang oxygen niya. Mawa na to ilhang lipong, kuyap, kakapoy, or confusion. Kana. What about mountain climbers, mga kaigsuunan? So we have a lot of mga Adventist friends who are into this. Murag bata pa ko hantod karon ga-climb gihapon ni sila. They actually have this challenge or mga challenges in breathing when they go so high up the sea level. Nga naman. When the mountain climbers go more than siguro 100 feet above the sea level, the air there tends to get thinner. Mas mubo ang atmospheric pressure, mas nipis ang hangin, so mas less ang oxygen content sa hangin dito. Malipong pod na sila. Malipong, mulabad ang o. Because your heart tends to pump faster, mosaka imong BP, kay feeling sa kasing-kasing, siya ang nagkulang, so siya ang mubumba. But actually, it's the air. Nga naman, ang birds, dili mo hunong mo ginhawa, no? As compared to us humans. You just look at them, they soar, mura sila di mo ginhawa. Murasad sila gwalay ilong-ilong ang uban birds. The birds have hollow bones, no? They have hollow bones. Their lungs also are exceedingly different from ours. Daghan silag chambers niya. It is designed nga murag ang chamber niya, mura siyag na ay roundabout path. So, sa iyahang kada kilid-kilid, all at the same time, makakuha siyag oxygen while flying. Di siya muhunong para mo pahuway ba? That's how fascinating the birds go about breathing. Now, I included some proper breathing technique, mga kaigsuonan, kay as what we know, ang atong paginhawa is something that we do not think of consciously. No? Maginhawa sa ako, nakalimot ko. No? Wala man na. No? That's part of our, it's actually a reflex, no? So when we breathe, ang proper technique, ana, whether lying down, sitting, or nagbarog, is in through the nose, out through the mouth. Dili. Dili ang ana. First lip. So, murag, first is murag pitaka. So, murag na nagoy. And you have to make sure that the exhalation is 2 to 3 times longer than the inhalation. So, when we breathe, pwede ninyo suwayan karon mga kaigsuonan. Guniti ang inyuhang tiyan. Hinhawa sa ilong. Dapat ang imong tiyan muburot. So, inhale through the nose. Exhale through the mouth. As simple as this practice is, this has been used to decrease stress and anxiety. Also in exercise, the timing of your breathing and your execution sa imong exercise, mosad na siya ang koan. Gina-emphasize with our teachers, no? So, yeah, this one, breathing during exercise. For example, if you are lifting a dumbbell or doing lunges, bisan unsa nga exercise, our teacher would always tell us, inhale to prepare. So, nagunit na ka ni dumbbell. Exhale, lift. Ana. So, when you execute, exhale na siya. Balita, no? Ana mo to. Mali. So, you want to do your execution of a certain exercise during the exhalation phase. So, inhale to prepare. Exhale. Ana. What about in COPD? Chronic obstructive pulmonary disease or hubak, asthma. Their airways are tight, no? Tight man ang ilang airway, huot ang ginhawa. The problem there is when they inhale, sa yun pagpasulod, ang lisod pagpagawas. So mura silang nag-breath stacking, no? Matrap ang air. So what we do is instruct them to do pursed lip breathing again but longer. So dili paspason ang ginhawa sa ilong. Nya. When you do pursed lip breathing, dili siya kanang ana lang, walay effort. You should feel that your core or ang imuhang tiyan is engaged, nangusog siya nya, mura kag ni bear down. Kung sa Bisaya pa mura kag ni utong. No? Ingana siya. It's like holding a balloon that's overinflated, na sobraan ni mo huyop ang balloon, anam-anam mo ni mo release ang air. So, ana. So that will help kay magkuan man ni sila, carbon dioxide retention, no? So very nice. Breathing cannot only help us relieve stress, it promotes good sleep. Daghan kayo siyag benefits. Relaxation, you get to focus better when your breathing is good, no? Daghan. However, there are certain conditions that we really need to support breathing. And not just the lungs. Sometimes, multifactorial siya. Suportaan na mo ang ginhawa kay nag-fail ang kasing-kasing. Pwede na siya. Suportaan ang ginhawa kay na-overwhelm siya sa infection. Suportaan ang ginhawa kay na-disgrasya. Nabali-bali ang mga gusok, dili, kalihok o tarong ang lungs. Suportaan ang ginhawa kay nalumos. Suportaan ang ginhawa kay nag-hang, nagbigti, or natukan, or nainaswalong coin baron, or any foreign object sa kadaghan nga reason. So what do we do when the lungs fail? Probably the most or the pinaka-end na nato nga mabuhat, no? If this is not from something that still can be manipulated, is mechanical ventilation. Ang Bisaya nga term ani mga kaigsuunan, hadlok siya paminawon because mura na siyang na-generic o sulti nga atong tubuhan. We are not actually slitting the patient's throat. Wala man tayo gibuhat. Wasa tayo gitusok nga dili bangag. Gipaagi regyo na siya ang tubo sa agianan sa hangin through the ba-ba. Because as what we know, ang atong oropharynx, inig nga nga gani na to ka nang magli-li-li-li ta sa bell kung hubag ba itong mga tonsil, nasamad ba, naabay bukog. Kana siyang opening din ha, muna ang main opening nga sa likod ana, if laumon pagyud na to, ang atubangan, ang ginhawaan, ang ilawm, ang tunlanan sa food. So sa kasilingan nila, maunang mga kanang makuyapan or kanang dili na kaayo maayo ang ilahang wakefulness mo aspirate kay ang ilahang laway mo adto man sila sa sudlanan sa hangin sa kaduol sa iyang bangag. So that is endotracheal intubation. Dili na siya hadlok mga kaigsuonan, ato lang gi diretso ang hangin sa airway. Next is non-invasive ventilation. Kung matara ang pasyente, wala na naog ang BP, dili kaayo siya critical, wala siya daghan plema, pwede ta magtaod og mask lang. So, the same concept, ang makina, muduot siya og hangin, it gives pressure para musud lang ang oxygen, and sometimes to relieve carbon dioxide. So, dapat kuan ang pasyente ani, mas awake compared to a mech vent, no? So non-invasive ventilation. Kung dili lang pud kaayo bati ang pasyente, unya need ra niya nga taas nga oxygen above sa kanang mask o kanang cannula ibutang sa ilong, we use the high flow nasal cannula that can deliver around 40 to 60 liters per minute. Kung kadtong mga dili na gusto magpatabang, pwede ra gyud kaayo bisag dili mata ang pasyente. O niya, gusto sila nga na ay oxygen, niya, wala na yung mga extraordinary measures, we give the high flow nasal cannula. Humukra na siya. Kung makakita mo atong prong, nasal prong, nga gahi nga plastic, that can only deliver 0 to 6 liters. This one, humuk siya niya, makina ang magduot. Now, this is what I've been trying to tell you. Our key text was read a while ago from Genesis when God created man and he breathed, no? Gave him life. Our second key text is found in the chapter of Ezekiel, that's 1 to 10. Remember, mga kaigsoonan, God gave a vision to Ezekiel. In fact, na gani mga kanta ani, na yung kanta, na yung mga cartoons, if you try to search sa YouTube, there's some materials that try to summarize this valley of dry bones. Mura man siyang sambingay mga kaigsuunan. Ezekiel 37, 4 to 5 reads, "Then he said to me, prophesy to these bones and say to them, dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. And this is what the sovereign Lord says to these bones, I will make breath enter you and you will come to life." Uga magyud na ang bukog, pastor, no? Ang mga basa nga bukog na sa bulalo. Dry bones, pasabot mga kaigsuonan, they have long been dead. Unsa man ni ang dry bones? We will try to take a look at this. So remember at the start of this talk, no? I talked about this already in passing. Katong sa atong number 2, the spiritual oxygen. So this chapter, Ezekiel 37, this basically began with God. Iyahang gipakita si Ezekiel dito sa certain valley na ay lugar nga naipatag niya na ay mga mountain sa kilid na puno og mga uga nga bukog, daghan kaayo. So yung giingnan si Ezekiel, prophesy unto these bones. Unya ingna sila nga magsumpay-sumpay. Kalisod. Kalisod. First year man gani may mag-dissect o kanang cadaver or kanang patayng lawas. Kalisod ipurma-purma, pastor. Walay ma-perfect. Daghan pa kay na attachment na pa'y mga tendon, kanang mga kagumkom nga atong kauno na mga puti, kanang crunchy-crunchy, inika-end sa joints mo ng mga tendon na pa'y cartilage rather. Mga tendon, kanang puti nga murag igbitad ni maso muscle na sa tumoy. Isod niya siya. And yet, when Ezekiel followed what he was told to do, nagsumpay-sumpay ang mga bukog. So, unsa man ni siya, mga kaigsoonan? What has this to do with our talk about the breath of life? Ingon ang Ginoo, he revealed to Ezekiel that these bones, katong mga bukog nga, mga uga na kaayo, they were not only dead, they were also disgraced. So remember, mga kaigsuunan, katong panahon na naapa in captivity sa Babylon, ang mga tao sa Ginoo. Wala pa sila na free. Taod-taod sa to, Pastor, no? 150 years maybe, or more or less. Dugay kaayo ba? Nobody lives to be that age anymore. So, pila na ka-generation ka, ha? Ibutang na to, duha, tulo ka-generation sa imong lulo, o ikaw, naghinuwat pa mo nga, dili na ma-slave or makauli sa inyong homeland. Asa na ang Ginoo, no? They were losing hope. So probably mo na ni ang mga representation of the our God's people nga wala gyud na lubong og kanang formal og tarong. These bones never observed a proper burial. Now allow me to read a parcel of Ezekiel 37:1-10 as a review of the story. Tulo ra ni ka slides mga kaigsuonan so that we will know what happened in this scenario, in this vision. The hand of the Lord was on me, ingon si Ezekiel. He brought me out of this by the Spirit of the Lord, so niadto sila somewhere, set me in the middle of the valley. It was full of bones. So he led me back and forth among them. Gipasuri-suri gyud sa Ginoo. I saw a great many bones. Great pa, many pa jud. Naghan gyud kay to. I saw a great many bones on the floor of the valley, and the bones were very dry. So he asked, Son of man, can these bones live? Mabuhi pa ba kaha ni? So of course, ang iyang tubag, bisan kita no? Ikaw ragyo kahibaw, Lord. Sovereign God, you alone know. Muna iyang tubag. And then he said to Ezekiel, prophesy to these bones. Muna itong gibasa ganiha. And say to them, dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. This is what the sovereign Lord says. I will make breath enter into you. Ka-imagine mo mga kaigsuonan. Bukog ra na. This is not a story of zombie-zombie or some horror movie that we are to dread of. This is a story of victory. Indot ni siya. I will attach tendons, specific kayo. Other versions will tell us sinews. To you and make flesh come upon you and cover you with skin. Lain sa kayo, bukog ra ang maglakaw-lakaw, unya magwali ang bukog. I will put breath in you. Kaduha gyud niya gisulti mga kaigsuonan. And you will come to life. Then you will know that I am the Lord. Moto ang purpose. So I prophesied, ingon si Ezekiel. Siya gyud ang ni-command. I was prophesying. There was a noise. Imagine ka nang murag ungo-ungo nga murag manglihok. Nag-rattle ang mga bones. Uga, good siya. Nag-sumpay-sumpay. No? Bone to bone. The bones came together bone to bone. I looked and the tendons and the flesh appeared to them. And skin covered them. But there was no breath in them. Nasumpay sila, pero di sila buhi. Murag ihapon siya og hadlok-hadlok. But the beautiful last two verses will tell us. Then the Lord said to Ezekiel, prophesy to the breath. So, di inasad na ang napurma nga bukog. Son of man, say it and say to it, this is what the sovereign Lord says. Come, breathe from the four winds and breathe into this slain that they may live. Yarang gi-command ang mga hangin, mga habagat, mga amihan. Ing ana ra, gi-command ra niya. So I prophesied, said Ezekiel, as he commanded me, and the breath entered them. They came to life ng barog. So they stood up on their feet and they became a vast army. Dili siya hadlok mga kaigsuunan, no? But it was a beautiful, beautiful vision. What was it about? Ngano mang yung dry bones? Ngano di na lang yung bones? These bones represented the people of Israel. So, no? A people who were living in exile. Wa man to sila sa ilhang homeland kay gi-capture man to sila. Far from their home, they were seemingly abandoned by their God, kadugay, more than 100 years in captivity. They were actually dead. But just like these bones, they will return to life. God will restore His people, bringing them out of their bondage from Babylon and returning them to their own land. This was actually fulfilled later by prophecy ni Isaiah. Na-fulfill ni siya partially later, a few years later, when the Persians conquered Babylon. And they allowed the Jews to return to their home. So ato siyang himay-himay yun. Just a few slides to help us really get into what this chapter is telling us. No? These bones are the house of Israel. No? Abi na to, basi nakasabot na ni si Ezekiel dayon, no? But it also, it might have surprised him, nga no, mangyud ka ni, nga nung bukog mangyud Lord, no? These are not just from the tribe of Judah, katong mga in favor, katong naasa mga higher nga court or sa mga dagko nga position among the Israelites. But these bones represent the whole house of Israel, no? When they fell into the Assyrians, kay gi-capture man to sila gipamatay. The bones were dry. This signifies that hope was lost. Sa kadugay na lang yun nila nga oppressed. And the Israelites felt that they were cut off. Their only hope for life and restoration was in God. Kani mga kaigsuunan, the beauty of it. So not all the bones were on the surface. Nanay na bury. Daghan biya kay to natapon ugan, no? Nagtapok-tap nag patong-patong na rather ang mga bones. Some were buried, but the Lord promised nga iyang kutkuton. I will open up the graves and cause you to come para maapil pug ka sa hangin, para maapil pug ka kabuhi. Bisag asa pa ta mo suksok. Bisag mo earthworm pa ka pangitaon ka sa Ginoo, kuhiton ka sa Ginoo, tagaan ka niyag hangin para mabuhi. And the beautiful promise of this vision is that God promised that He will bring His people back to their land. Parihas na to. Kung asa ta na sa agsaag, because of our sinful nature, God will always find a way for the transformation to take place in our lives. And then you shall know that He is the Lord. Napadyo'y bonus. When God makes you alive and well again, He will put His Spirit within you. Para di lang ka mo barog, mabuhi na iunod, but mabuhi ka spiritually. How then do we apply this to our modern day living? Sa una raman na to, Old Testament pa man to. What about now? You know, our sins have separated us from the Lord. The Holy Spirit has been trying to call us, to convict us of sin. In this era, especially sa mga batan-on, what was wrong years ago was slowly creeping as something okay nowadays. Pwede na na, okay na na, di lagi na sa. We have been spiritually dead, mga kaigsuunan. But take heart. And have courage because God has breathed new life into us. Unsa man ato ang pagduol sa source of oxygen or the breath of life, no? Although we know this, we are made alive in Christ. What do we do to sustain our lives, no? For us to experience revival, no? Restoration. Revival is nagluya ka. Nabuhi ang imong espiritu. Restoration, probably. Pasig nasamad ka, nasakitan ka. Nabuak ang atong mga vessel, no? Pero naayo ra siya, naplasteran ra. Reformation is change in character. Nga di na to magbalik-balik sa karaan nga sa. Because when you, God, forgive us, we have to move forward and forget about the past. Sins and no longer do it, and we listen to the Holy Spirit. Unsaon man siya mga kaigsuunan? We must know, no? We must walk among the dead. No? God's servants must walk among the dead. So dili ra pud nimo tagdon ang katong mga dasigra. Tagdon pud nato, no? That is why we allot some of our time during the Sabbath afternoons to visit kato atong mga kaigsuunan nga kanang wala na kaayo nakita nato sa church, mga ingana. We have also to know that the Spirit works in a process. Dili man na siya magic overnight nga niampu ta karon Lord, humuka yang kasing-kasing, humok na yang kasing-kasing inig kaugma. It takes time. Takes a lot of patience and prayer. We have to recognize that without the Holy Spirit's work, wala gyud tayo mabuhat, no? The Holy Spirit's work is essential. That's why we have to pray for the Spirit to move. We have to speak in the power of faith. Mutuo ta nga kaya na buhaton sa Ginoo. And we must not lose hope. Diba? Seventh-day Adventist, we are God's chosen people. Kita ang nagdala sa suga. We are not to lose hope. So if you can see, mga kaigsuunan, so Doc, what do you mean by plugging into the source of spiritual oxygen? Kana day atong morning og evening worship. Our 777 prayer habit. The devotionals in our workplace, og sa ato ang church, the personal quiet meditation that you do before your day gets busy. Kana. And the fellowship, nganong mo anhi man kita sa simbahan, traffic man, mapliti pa. The fellowship and the blessing of the fellowship and, you know, getting encouraged with your brethren is another blessing that is a form of plugging into the source of our spiritual oxygen. Remember, mga kaigsuunan, dili siya sundalo ra ang nabuhat atong mga dry bones. They were a vast army. So I don't know, I cannot count, no? There were no numbers, pero daghan kaayo to. Imagine from being just plain bones, murag mga useless, mga uga, mga walay gamit, walay life. God transformed them into a vast, mighty army. So kita, nga nagkatulog, probably we got tired because of our paningkamot na makasurvive. But we have to check that we are part of one entire body. So, ang simbahan, ang body, part pa sa lawas. So para makalihok ta, we can move on, we have to enlist in this army, mga kaigsuunan. And it is my prayer that tonight, may we never ever run out of reasons to keep breathing our spiritual oxygen. May we never ever stray away from the source, which is God. May we always strive to share the wonderful news of salvation and hope, especially to those who do not know Christ yet. And may we never lose sight of that blessed hope that someday in the clouds of heaven, the source of life himself will call us and bring us all to heaven, where there will be no more evil existing. There will be no more sickness, no more death, no more suffering. Before I end this talk, mga kaigsuunan, allow me to share one of our advocacies in the church, which is the Adventist professionals. No? Ang atong Adventist professionals, mga kaigsuunan, very quickly, I would like to remind you to enlist in this. You can take a picture of that and then sign up. It will help us get a roster or lista sa ato ang mga Adventist professionals. We are moving towards, if you remember our theme for TMI, our total membership involvement, no? Ulihok man taas one, but we are broken down into mga gagbay-gagbay nga grupo para mas paspas. So natay mga care group. Dili ta magkontra sa ato ang mga Federation of Churches. Actually, this is just part and parcel of the church, but need trabaho ta as laymen, no? in partnership with ASI or the Adventist Services, Layman Services Incorporated, ang atong mga Adventist nga business owners, the Adventist professionals also have representations, especially in the government sectors, saka ng mga, this is not just about elite evangelism. Ang atong mga nabuhat mga kaigsunan, as far as when the pandemic started, we distributed food, mga sanitation, essentials, mga PPE sa prisuhan, sigit biya kay sila dito, government hospitals. We gave them materials to read as well as food and PPE, gloves and all. Nagbisita ta sa mga major big schools and universities here in Metro Cebu. Girecognize na to ang ilang mga dean who allow their Adventist students to observe the Sabbath if it falls on a certain school activity na taana mga kaigsuonan. So this is not just something for grupo-grupo lang kay para ma-separate ang professional og non-professional. No. This will give us a representation in whatever platform we use ug asa ta mo adto. Help us pray for this big crusade that will be happening. That's July 14 to 20. To be announced pa ang ato ang venue here in Metro Cebu, but the groundworks have already started few months back sa mga probinsya. So kanisiya magdala ta og mga, di ba kay we live in the metro, no? Naman ta sa mga urban area. So we can bring, especially ang atong mga working population, we can bring our friends nga naandam na nato, invite nato ani nga event, not just for this, but we can help them prepare to get to know the Lord. Kung maglisod ta og Bible study, ma-refer nato sa ato ang mga layman, pwede ta makapangutana sa atong pastor. We try to invite them because, you know, the message of salvation is that God is love. Really, God is religion, no. God is love. Something so wonderful as that, di ba? Kung nindot kayo nga ito ang ma-feel, di man na ito ma-try o tago, it will always show. So you will always want to share, nindot kayo ang Ginoo sa akong kinabuhi. You can start with that. You can start with sharing your sudan, nga probably a healthier version of what they used to know. You can start bringing them to your favorite sports. We can start sharing the healthy lifestyle, which is also part of our medical missionary work. Kusgun ba ninyo ang inyong volume in worship para mag-echo-echo ang inyong tingog? O niya, maminaw sila? Kinsa man itong nag-blending-blending? O na ay nagtukar-tukar itong instrument? Kinsa man to sila? And they will come to know. Or muhumot ang atong sudan in Friday o Saturday kay special compared sa other days. There's a lot to do in this field, no? Lapad kayo ang field, pero ang mga magbubuhat, the workers are few. So, the pastors, ang atong mga workers, cannot do all this. We all have to help in our own little way. Thank you so much for being with us and spending this midweek prayer service tonight. May we all be blessed.
Iksuon ko dasigdan. kung dasig ta karon, dasig sa taog ma, kay basin ang Ginoo, mubalik na uniya. Kung kita dili andam, unsaon na lang kaha, magpabili na lang bata, dinhi sa yuta. Kung ikaw daghan o problema, ayaw lang kabala ka kay si Jesus nga imong Dios, andam para tabangan ka.
Atong daygo na Ginoo ining ka gabihion mga kaigsoonan sa nindot nga mensahe ni Doc Michelle. Kumusta ang atong spiritual breath, ha? Ang atong paginhawa din ha. Tarong pa nang ginhawa mga kaigsoonan o galisod ta ginhawa. Ha? Kinahanglan ba si kinahanglan na deep breathing. Unya labos tanan mga kaigsoonan spiritual breath para maayo gyud, mas maayo gyud mo apil ta sa buhat. So thank you sa nindot kayo nga message nining kagabhion mga kaigsoonan. Di ata panahon sa ato ang prayer ban or prayer request. Kung pasalamatan ang ato ang mga kaigsoonan, mga online viewers nga kadunay nagpadala sa taas kayo permanente nga listahan sa prayer request. Salamat nga nagatuo kamo og unsa ka importante ang pag-ampo. Just sa miagi mga kaigsoonan, I got very much happy hearing kay usa sa ato ang member din sa atong church, si Brother A.G. Sam Gunisto. Nakapasar siya mga kaigsoonan sa iyang mid-tech. Ako siyang gi-congratulate. Pag-congratulate nako, miingon siya nako, abi nimo pastor, na ako'y gi-appeal sa prayer request nato sa Cebu City is your church, napulo kabuok, dili mga Adventist. Ingon siya, kay balo ka pastor, tanan sila mipasar sa mid-tech exam. So praise the Lord mga kaigsoonan. Thank you for believing the power of God mga kaigsoonan sa pag-answer sa ato ang mga prayer request. Now, let's start reading these names. For healing and recovery mga kaigsoonan nga gahandom nga makaangkon mga kaigsoonan og hingpit nga kayuhan tungod sa ilang balatian. Una din ni mao si Romeo Flores III, Flory Bacos, Elizabeth Macarini, Rosing Campesino, Elena Ramirez Abisamis, George Rois, Charlie Balbero, PB Nuval Rivera, Lagrimas Pabol, Marilyn Hongko, Marilyn Hongko, Fidila Mendoza, Marilyn Mistola, Tata Bustillo, Abraham Carbonella, Martina Hongko, Rogelio Tumakay, Glindy Oliva, Hara Melissa Bacos, Lynn Ikea, Dolores Filo, Rosalyn Paca, Josephine Herediano, Elvera Cabanas, Nempha Basnelio. We have also for we have Sister J. Lee Ne Makapiot for midwifery licensure exam. June Carpentero, CPE board exam. Monsor Lapos, Napolcom exam. We have also here names of electrical engineering waiting for the board exam, electrical engineering students. We have Erlyn Siroy, Jim Bisas, Kent Awid Harovelia, Din Turid, Sai Ria Pilo, Michaela Ismero, Joyce Dimi, Edgar Paner, Josia Malinis, Karel Apa, Jake Cabatino, Rachel Mapiso, Rindel Villegas, Raimondo Igdon, Shelly Dabon, Maribeth Garciso, Andrian Canoy, Greg Disierdo, Israel Verdeda, Lisel May David, Norlin Cabo Caloberan, Kent Walter Lim, Kent Nabaselia, Selwin Dio Alpas, Monro Esparago, Jose Miguel Pagayon, Vic Berto, Ferdinand Carpis, Ray Angelo Clementier, Hanami Cabreba, Judy Rich Lois Bilguera, Rani Aginsatan. We have also nursing board examination. These are the following names. Shera Jane Palarao, Noemi Gallego, Gladi May Polestico, Danica Sanchez, Nisel Kate Taripi, Christine Payos, Gasel Jane Tabunan, Rain May Limbaga. We have also PRC examination takers, Sin Daniel Jongko, Aaron Lloyd Paho, Lance Haspi, Mark Lindano, Friends John Delante, Daniel Apiag, Iris Dinsel Pahe, Aisa May Katayas, Krisa May Andit, Jister Empleado, John Lloyd Tilin, Shemer Khan Waram, Joshua Del Puso, Rina Rich Abiliano. We have Miasiel Angelo Alcido, Joshua Diocampo, Gisa Alarba, Aaron Sinilong, Mark Jacob. We will be praying also our Bible students in Cebu City Jail male dormitory. And we have also our ongoing church projects. We have Tablon, Placer, Dumlog, Kabangahan, Langob, Tisa, Argao, Tramo, and Valencia is the church. Mga kaigsoonan, akong gihangyo ang tanan sa pagluhod alang sa ato ang pagampo. Among silimbahon, dalay ko na mo nga Diyos, Ama na mo nga nakas mga langit. Kami mapasalamaton kanimo sa nindot na mensahe nga naga giya ka namo, nagtultol ka namo so sa kaispirituhanon nga pagkinabuhi sama sa Ginhawa, kinahanglan amo kini nga himuon, kinahanglan og exercise ang amo usab nga espirituhanon nga pagalaga diya kanimo. Tabangi kami nga mamahimo kami Amahan nga imong anak nga matinumanon diha kanimo imong mga anak nga nagalagad uban sa imong grasya ug balaan nga espiritu nga magagiya kanamo. Ini kagabion dalaygon nga Dios among nabasa ang mga daghan nga mga pangalan nga dunay mga balatian. Sila amahan nagapadayon sa pagsampit kanimo tungod kay nasayod sila o nasayod kami. Ikaw ang Ginoo nga makagahom sa tanan ug ikaw arang makaayo sa mga balatian sa imong mga anak. Arang ikaw makatabang ato kanila aron mamahimong instrumento ang mga doktor, ang mga tambal nga ilahang gidapat sa ilang lawas aron madugangan ang ilahang kinabuhi ug labaw sa tanan. Kanunay sila magaday kanimo nga aduna kami Ginoo nga makagahom sa tanan nga andam muayos mga balatian. Dalaygon nga Dios amo usab ginaampo ang mga daghan nimong mga anak nga dunay mga board examination schedules. Dalaygon nga Ginoo ikaw na sayod ugon sa ilang mga paningkamot. Unsa pod kadako sa paningkamot sa mga ginikanan aron sila makabayad sa ilahang mga tuition fees o karon amahan nakatapos na sila apan mao na usab kining panahon ang katapusan o ultimatum sa ilahang pag-eskwela mao ang ilang board exam. Nasayod kami nga kini nga katuyuan mamahimo lamang sila sa pagpasar aron magamit nila makatrabaho sila o mamahimo silang panalangin sa ilang panimalay. Pero gikinahanglan namo ang imong panabang o gikinahanglan namo ang imong pag-iya. Dalaygon nga Dios among ginasabmitar ang tanan sa usa ka paglaom nga ikaw magadungog sa among mga pangaliupo nini kagabion. Di na po yung mga kaigsuunan online, mga kaigsuunan di sa church, mahimo amahan nga wala sila nakapa-appeal sa listahan sa mga pangalan. Apan nasayod kami amahan nga ikaw ang nakahibalo nga matago sa kanila, doon ay mga nagkalahilahe, lahilahe nga burden sa ilang kinabuhi. Babangi amahan, among ginasampit ka ni mong tanan. Tungod kay nasayod kami, walay butang imposible diya sa mga tubangan. Dalaygon nga Dios, among usab ginaampo kanimo nga ikaw magauban niining mga simbahan nga nagapadayon sa katukuran nga uban kanila dugay nakaayo Ginoo nga gitukod apan wala pa nahuman tungod sa kakulang sa materialis alang niini. Among ginadangop kanimo nagapadayon sila sa paghangyo nga ikaw magagamit og uban nga mga tao alang sa kahimuan niini og labaw sa tanan. Ikaw magapadayon sa pagpanalangin sa mga membro diin sila nagpasakop aron mamahimo usab silang instrumento alang niini nga katuyuan og sila makabaton amahan og grasya og panalangin og ang maong mga balay nga lampuanan matapos. Dalaygon nga Ginoo, daghang salamat sa imong pagtubag sa mga pagampo. Daghang salamat niini kagabion nga nakadungog kami og mga nindot nga mensahe. Tabangi nga among nabatian karon mahimo usab gini kabahin sa among kinabuhi samtang kami magapadayon sa pag-alagad kanimo sa ngalan ni Jesus nga among luluwas. Amen.
Draw me nearer for our closing song, hymn number 187. Requesting everyone to please rise. Thank you.
Gracious Lord, we thank Thee for the freedom of worship. And we recognize the signs of Your soon coming is very near. Empower us with the Holy Spirit, Father, that we may be able to continue to encourage each other as we continue to serve You, as we wait for Your soon coming. This we ask in Jesus' wonderful name. Amen.